But you already know, you can't hardly surprise no 50-year-old woman.
37, 38.
Not a single cigarette, no.
Hey, you gotta live in a hood to get a single cigarette, you know? It's Angie's birthday. It's a real G's B-Day. It's a G-Day. Friday night, it's like around 9:30 p.m. looking whoo, but it's not right because I ain't going nowhere. I ain't been nowhere. Well, actually, I did go out to pick up medicine, but I didn't get the car, so you know, it don't count, right? My sister tired. I'm really trying to figure out what I can wear to the bestie's birthday party. This is bestie number one, and I only say number one because I met her first, not in order of importance nor love, but just chronological. So it's Angie's birthday, and it's a surprise birthday, but you already know, you can't hardly surprise no 50-year-old woman, because when folks start moving different, we immediately pick up on it. So she definitely knows something is up. But I was like, we going thrifting, come to my house by 11, get cute, I'm gonna take you to lunch for your birthday, and that's that. And at first she wouldn't agree to it because she's like, I don't know, my kids haven't said they're doing anything. So I had to text her daughter, Vonnikins, Von Von, like, look, Von Von, tell your mama y'all doing something on Sunday so she'll come outside so I can drag her out on Saturday. So she did, and Angie agreed. All right, love y'all. I'll see y'all tomorrow. We're going to have fun, and it's going to be a party, y'all. I'm gonna fall asleep somewhere. But it's gonna be a party, y'all. Peace and blessings. Hey, y'all. How you doing? Come on in. Make yourself at home. Feel free to be yourself, because I'm going to be me. It's your girl, Black Butterfly, or Jenny, or Butterfly, or Bubby Annie. Anyway, I am out and about with the bestie. Say hi, bestie.
Hi, bestie.
It's Angie's birthday. It's a real G's B-Day. It's a G-Day. So, yes, honey. Big 5-0, baby. Black don't crack. Black don't crack. So, we are, man, we went thrifting.
That's what old folks do.
We were, I know, right? We were just supposed to be getting, I was looking for a dresser for my dressing room, which right now is just a junk room where everything is everywhere. And I'm just gonna have to order something that looks like. We just didn't have any luck today. So since we didn't have any luck with that, which I shouldn't say we didn't have any luck, because we found a lot. Yes, yes. We found a lot of great wicker stuff, serving stuff. Yeah, some really awesome serving bowls, wooden platters. I'm preparing for next year for my farm to table dinners and some of the events that I'm going to throw, particularly once we get the second phase to move the yard together, the fire pit and all that. So being able to do stuff outside for me is, you know, safest from a standpoint. And plus, it's outside. Like, who doesn't want to be outside in nature? nature and feeling the breeze and the trees and all that good stuff. So anyway, speaking of breeze and trees and stuff, we are going to go to Writing, Feed, and Seed, which is a plant store.
And a feed store.
And a feed store, because this is Ohio. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, lots of animals. Country. We're country.
Yes.
Everybody else would put it.
Well, I'm finding that we are. We just don't think we are.
Right.
Like,
every time I talk, they like,
where you from?
Down south? No.
Right.
Up north.
We think we city-fied. We are not city-fied, honey. We're as country as you want to be. And especially when I go to California, is when I realize
that you have an accent too,
baby. Yes, yes. Which, the older I get, the more I lean into my Ebonics and my countryness, especially since I don't have to go to no white man's job no more.
Ooh, they got some big ones too.
Angie just got geeked because she saw the mumps in a row. She coming in hot. Oh my god,
coming in hot.
She gonna kill all the people.
Oh, they got the
people grabbing their children.
Okay.
Oh my god. All right. I will film when it's safe and we are parked. Ooh, look at those mountains. Gorgeous. More pumpkin. These look like they've lived a long, hard life, but that's why they're on super sale. Okay, so here's the damage. $74. You're welcome. Happy birthday. And then on the way out the door, we found these pillows for $8.99 each, which are longer than the pillows I bought just last week for the gazebola, which were $24.99 each. So, yeah. All right. We did a little damage today, but not a lot. It wasn't that bad. I think I only spent like $150 today so far. We still got to eat lunch. I think I've given up on trying to find a dresser today. I'm just going to order one from IKEA or Walmart or Amazon somewhere. I should have ordered one on Prime Day. But at any rate, I'll find something. I'm really tired. To be honest, my chest is kind of hurting in a weird way. Not in a heart way, but a lung way. And it just might be the fact that I was doing a lot of walking, and the temperature. It's not cold, but it's in the 60s. It is brisk. It's a brisk breeze. But at any rate, it is a beautiful fall day in Ohio. Like, beautiful, beautiful. So I always feel bad. Angie's back there loading the car, struggling, and I'm in here. Ooh, excuse me. Coke icy. Chilling. Anyway,
all
right.
Want to go to Valley Thrift?
I don't think I got Valley Thrift walking in me. Mm. All right, I'll check in a little bit. That'll be a good garden basket once I take that Christmas thing. Even though I like that dark basket, I generally don't favor the dark.
I don't like the darkies.
Color.
I don't like the darkies. You're a light skin freak.
It doesn't meet my aesthetic, but I'm exactly the opposite because I love me some chocolate brothers. However,
not in the floor.
Right. Because my living room is that, and I think I'm over. And I ain't coming off the chunky two-handed basket because I love it, even though it's not the right color, but I figure I could use that in the garden.
Way more than $2.
I know.
$5.
I'm gonna tell you honestly, I feel so about that tray too with the leather handles.
want that one? I'll take it.
Mm-hmm. And oh gosh. Damn, what was that? Look at that big ass bumblebee. Oh my gosh, look at how huge he is. He came at me.
Okay. So Angie left my house probably about 3 minutes before I did. Which, since Angie drives like a freaking speed demon, she's already home. So I know I'm gonna miss the actual surprise part, but my job was to keep her busy and to keep her out of the way all day, which mission accomplished. We went thrifting, we went plant shopping, which are two of both of our favorite things. We sat out in the gazebo and talked shop, talked about plants and gardening for like an hour. We went through our little haul, which I showed you guys a part of. So I'm not gonna say I'm sorry, because I understand things had to happen as they did, but I wish I could have been there for Angie to see her get the surprise. But basically, because it started out as a deck, and then we added the pergola, but then we closed it in to make it a gazebo, or at least covered it. So that's how we get gazebola, and how Nicole gets deca-bugala, I don't know, deca-bugala. I don't know. I had to let her tell y'all. Imagine some weird time loop type thing. I'm gonna go back and give y'all the earlier days in my waiting kind of volume. And one thing you will notice is I have gained weight. Like in the beginning, I was very thin. Which the funny part is, my whole life before I got sick, I was always trying to lose 20 pounds. Now, I was thick witty probably up until my 30s when I started to really get sick. And even then, I wasn't sick like this. I just knew that something was going on, that I was losing weight, that I was really tired, that I was getting these rashes. And for me, that was the beginning of sarcoid, that my joints hurt, that I would be so sore back then. And I just didn't quite know. And I went to a few doctors. And, you know, you had a virus. It's this, it's that. It's allergies, it's asthma. It's a combination of all these things. But sarcoid is hard to diagnose. It does present different kind of in each person. That sort of all over body inflammation seems to localize in different places for different people. So again, it's kind of hard to pin down, besides the fact that there just seems to be these inflammation markers that everyone seems to have. And then like bronchoscopy for pulmonary sarcoid is kind of the best way. Even though I did have the granulomas, which are like these little thingies, like hard tissue growths that form under your skin in certain places. But again, no one was putting all the pieces together. So at that time, I wasn't putting all the pieces together. I just knew that, I just kept telling folks, like, I don't feel right. All of a sudden, I feel like I'm dragging my body around. This road is so crappy. What's so interesting to me is Angie's neighborhood and Nicole's neighborhood, they live closer to each other than I do. It's one of the kind of next in the process of getting gentrified neighborhoods. So certain things are prioritized different. Like their business district has certainly changed. That road has been paved. They put a decorative bridge in down the street that serves absolutely no purpose. But the little part of the road that goes through the hood, well, y'all saw we bunk all the way here. It's very interesting. And Cincinnati is one of those cities where we like to think that because we're not the South, we ain't the South, but we very much are. Did y'all surprise her? Oh, I wish I could have been there, but you know, Angie drives fast as hell. It's okay. I knew I was gonna not be able to do that, so it's all right.
She looked like an Asian. She was like, you gonna pull up?
This is the click.
Right.
I was oh my God, I know the whole Saudi.
Yeah. Yeah. I was over here like.
Birthday. Thank you, God, for another day.
Yes, God.
I'm 15 years old. I don't look it, but I
am. Amen. Amen.
And
I'm
sure. I'm she is named you.
Amen. Amen. Yo, mama and your cousins too.
I said 83.
It's 73 or 81, people.
It's 73.
Oh, 81. I'm making up numbers. That's not.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, she's 5.
Everybody says she's 5 too.
She's 5 too.
It has always been.
She's fine too.
She's fine. Okay.
She's fine too.
All right.
But I want you.
She's fine too, but I want you.
Oh, like she's fine too, but I want you.
But you. They think that she's 5 too.
Right. And I was thinking, like, she fine too. Never mind.
Oh, yeah,
right. In what year did the first Air Jordan shoe release?
What year the Jordan shoe release?
The first Air Jordan shoe release. 1985, 1990, 1986,
1983. Is it
5 or 6? 5, 90, 86, 83. 85. Yes. Fun fact, I never ever had a pair of Jordans my whole life.
It could have been the time.
And that's why Siri's first shoes was a pair of pink Jordans. Yes.
Oh, that's like naming your daughter Alexis.
I know, right? Exactly.
So precious.
It's so hood, but you know, good with good intentions.
Wait, wait, wait,
time out, man. Look at Auntie.
Only one I want to see.
He keeps talking about it.
Because
you know what Jesus look like? He said he don't want no graven images. No bringing them in.
I don't want the white
people.
They like Esa
Harris. Yes, they do. Me too.
Who was tased at Coachella?
Ooh. Ha, I'm a girl.
Issa, Molly, Tiffany, or Kelly?
Tiffany?
Oh, these five ones.
Kelly. Remember me different. And fun fact, she was not even supposed to be on the show. She was actually a writer. And she was so funny on the table read, so they was like, you're hired. That's your role.
Aww.
Yes.
Black people call this disease the sugar.
Girl, diabetes.
Diabetes.
You
got your sugar diabetes.
Yeah,
sugar.
That was too easy.
That was real, real easy.
Oh my God.
You got that sugar.
Is it my time already?
You got them beaties.
Okay, we know who you are. Okay.
Okay. On the movie Friday, how much money did Smokey's mom give him to buy cigarettes in the store? $7, $10, $5, or $1?
$5.
His mama was she wanted a single cigarette. She wanted a cigarette. She wanted a single.
Not a single cigarette, no.
Yeah, you gotta live in a hood to get a single cigarette. You know? Liquor.
Dark liquor.
Vodka. Girl, you black as hell. I knew somebody was gonna say dark.
It's cognac.
Vodka, whiskey, cognac, or gin. Alright, y'all, it's that yak. Y'all know it's that yak. Chuckaloosa, Mississippi. Chuckaloosa.
I heard about that show.
But did you know that the show is actually based off the life of the famous stripper Gigi McGuire? And
no one knows.
That is, y'all don't know who Gigi McGuire is?
No.
Y'all don't know y'all strippers. What kind of
Coming to America?
Yep.
Ah, what?
What?
Opening the doors.
Open the floodgates to heaven.
Windows.
It's a thing.
It's a box. It's a TV.
It's a thing. All right. An elevator.
Going up. The Jefferson.
Who got smart?
Elevator to hell.
Jason Beyonce in the elevator.
I'm headed back to the homestead. It was fun. I love getting with my people. This is kind of our original clique from back in the day, you know. This is family, very much so. All our kids grew up together and it was nice. Everybody was there except for Camille, which is Nicole's youngest. My daughter Siri, who is working, who's performing at Blink. I know after this weekend, she's gonna want to sleep 1,000 days, but she cannot because she's back in it on Monday. But at any rate, this was nice. Okay, it's kind of dim in here, but hopefully you can see. Here's the outfit for today. This is the sweater I got from Lovely Warehouse. The skirt is from Shein. It has a really cute detail on it that you can't see because of my shirt, but I'll wear this again. Ooh, my pouch might hide it too, but it has this cute scrunch detail. But anyway, I really, really like this. Sorry for the camera work. Really, really like this thing. It feels very flowy and elegant and stuff. So anyway, Lovely Wholesale, Shein. Ain't no telling how long ago I got this head wrap. These earrings, I believe I got from Shein a long time ago, but I can't be sure. This link bracelet from Shein. Assorted gold rings from Shein. This Ankh, which is something that I wear every day, all the time, was given to me by a friend a long time ago. So yeah, oh, the cute boots I had on, which I already took off, knee-high burgundy boots were from, I believe, Just Fab, like years ago. So anyway, that's the fit. I feel like it's giving rich auntie. I'm going to bed. I'm tired. Running around all day, that's a lot for me by itself. But especially running around and then partying and then being in the cold, I'm tired. I love y'all. Good night. In the light. Okay, beautiful people. I always try to find a way to sneak some garden footage in. So this was the night of the meteor shower. It was a great night with the glam kids and some of the tribe family. If you know, you know. And we stargazed in kiddie pools, watched some movies, ate good, had a baby bonfire, and just had an awesome night under the stars. And you know, this is the way that I find the joy in the wait. This is how I get by. These moments, like Angie's birthday and this night, are very much the ones that sustain me and allow me to continue to find the joy as I wait to inhale.
Know you see this light on me is beaming.